Lebanon's political deadlock has no easy solution. The Beirut blast has crippled an already failing state. And now Lebanon's prime minister-designate has stepped down amid an impasse over government formation. Mustapha Adib has announced his resignation after his efforts to line up a non-partisan cabinet ran into trouble. In a televised address, Adib said that he was stepping down from the task of forming the government following a meeting with the president.
ومع وصول المجهود لتشكيل الحكومة إلى مراحله الأخيرة تبين لي بأن هذا التوافق الذي على أساسه قبلت هذه المهمة الوطنية في هذا الصرف الصعب من تاريخ لبنان لم يعد قائما وبما أن تشكيلة بالمواصفات التي وضعتها باتت محكومة سلفا بالفشل وحرصا مني على الوحدة الوطنية بدستوريتها ومصداقيته فإنني أعتذر عن متابعة مهمة تشكيل الحكومة متمنيا
The formation of government in Lebanon has been hit by a logjam over the demand of two dominant Shia parties, Iran-backed Hezbollah and its ally, the Amal movement, to name Shia ministers in the cabinet, and the efforts to form the Lebanese government failed, despite the French pressure on the sectarian leaders to rally together to deal with the worst crisis since a 1975 to 1990 civil war. There has been an acute economic and political crisis that is endangering people's basic rights in Lebanon. And people have lost confidence in the political establishment. Lebanese security forces, including army personnel, internal security forces and parliament police, have used excessive force on several occasions against demonstrators. Lebanon continues to criminalize peaceful speech, and prosecutions against people exercising their free speech rights have increased sharply since 2015. Lebanon has a history of war and destruction. The sectarian walls divide the people of Lebanon, and Lebanon has been crippled by a number of long-running, seemingly intractable crises for decades. And the country endured a devastating 15-year civil war and has often been caught in the crossfire of regional conflicts. And now it has been crushed by a mounting debt crisis, and Lebanon's banks are paralyzed and its currency is in free fall. Following the resignation of the government in the wake of the August 4th explosion, France has been pushing for the quick formation of a new cabinet. It has also offered to help provide Lebanon with vital aid if its politicians make good on the long overdue reforms. But efforts to get Lebanon's fractious leaders to agree on a new government in order to start fixing the country's problems have yet to bear fruit. CNN's former Beirut bureau chief Brent Sadler gets us more on this.
Latest development is yet another hammer blow to an already cataclysmic situation economically, financially, and politically for Lebanon. In terms of the Macron, the President of France initiative, it's shut the door effectively on that initiative, which Macron himself was probably the last chance for the Lebanese to be able to form a government, a sustainable, respectable government of independent specialists on their own, to try to open the doors to international monetary fund support, to try to prevent the country further spiraling out of deeper control. Already today, the value of the Lebanese pound has dropped sharply against the dollar. Already prices are skyrocketing, inflation, hyperinflation, increasing by the hour, according to experts on the ground. So the outlook is dismal. And you have to look at this in the context of Iran and its political allies in Lebanon, not least the armed Hezbollah group, the militant group which the United States and many European nations call a terror organization, is digging its heels in and not allowing the government to be formed. And that is why the prime minister designate has just resigned.